Well, hello. Welcome back to another episode of ATS versus Real Trucking. This is my Peterbilt 379. And on our last episode, my girlfriend and I had rolled into Gallup last night with this heavy load, 90,000 pound load. Spent the night here, and we're on our way to Albuquerque. We just went over to Starbucks over there and got ourselves some cups of Joe. She's back there reading her book again, and we're ready to roll. Just like that. Sorry, Bob. Don't want anybody try to cut me out there. I'm gonna swing wide here. So, 3 hours we'll be there. And we'll see about getting another load out. Seat back, and I forgot to slide it back forward again. Pass you, Mr. Carrier. Thank you. hard to believe how long this load is. Should have got diesel there last night. That was over $4 a gallon where I got it. It's a $3.48 there? God. South of here, judging by the trip thing. So this is going to be south of Albuquerque.
Keep left. Keep right.
I tell you, I am going to be happy to get rid of this load. It is very heavy. My fuel mileage has dropped to 5.2 miles per gallon average, and I'm on the throttle all the way, and I'm average, you know, at the moment 3.6 miles per gallon. So. She's heavy. Am I not getting up here? I thought I was.
Keep right.
Okay.
Then take the exit right. Take the exit right. Right turn ahead.
Got a green line, look at that.
Turn right.
just in time.
Keep right, then turn right. Turn right.
Jump the curb there.
Left turn ahead. Turn left. Turn ahead.
Just one of these.
Turn right.
UPS radios.
You have reached your destination.
Guess I have. There it is, straight ahead. Boy, like I said, I'll be happy to get this one off. This was a monster load. Paid me like $1,200 or so. Guess it was worth it. All right, what's going on? Am I not on the line? I am. Just gotta go forward more than I usually do. There we are. Set the brakes. Check the current company job offers. Albuquerque to Hobbs. Don't want to go that way. Las Cruces. Don't really want to go that way. Well, that's all. Tulane doesn't pay that great. But home is up that way, so. Yeah, it goes up to Raton and then cuts east. And that's probably going to be the one I want right there. A lightweight load. Let's do it. Next question. Where is it? Oh. Yes, I see a flashing arrow back there. Just gonna leave her running on this one. Check the map real quick. Make sure it's not gonna go anywhere kind of unusual, because every once in a while you'll see it routing you in a strange way. So far, so good. This is roadway I haven't been on yet, but once we get over here to Lamar, I have been here, so this is good. And home is right here in Salina, so definitely heading the right direction. While I'm here, let me adjust the seats. All right. We'll get there at 7 o'clock tonight. But sounds good. It's lightweight. I don't need granny gear. So kind of do my standard ship pattern, which is first, third, fifth, sixth, seventh, split seven, split eight. Definitely going to make the corners more manageable than they have been.
Left turn ahead. Turn left. Right turn ahead. Turn right.
So much lighter.
Left turn ahead. Turn left.
Sneaking through. the left light. Yeah, yellow light again. I'd like to, I can't. What? Yes, I have someone on my right. I'm turning left, thank you. Splitting these gears because it's uphill. Just to explain what's going on here. It's supposed to be in 7 low there, though. I don't know why I didn't make the jump. Speeding already. My goodness, so much different than the other load.
Keep left.
Now we're on I-25 northbound out of Albuquerque. There's the skyline. This is that giant mix master we went over yesterday. Yesterday we were westbound, today we are northbound. Up towards Santa Fe, New Mexico, and then up to Raton. I don't know if it's Raton or Raton, but... And then from there, we take 2-lane roads, apparently, going to the east. As I was explaining in the last series or last video, trying to show the difference between the games trucking, you know, the life of a truck driver versus what it would be like in real life. Instead of 14-hour days, you're only allowed 11 hours on duty. And then you gotta sleep for 10. Also the other issues that might come up, when I started out on this video, the problem in the truck stop trying to get across the Catskills. This is an interesting deal. It's like a light rail from here down into Albuquerque. I guess there must be a lot of suburbs up here, and Santa Fe is up here as well. But, you know, if that was the case, why doesn't it go into Santa Fe? It comes up here and then stops. Anywho, it does exist. It is there. I've been up these roads. It is there. So, if any of you know, is it to Santa Fe, and do they have buses that leave from here, or does the light rail go into Santa Fe? Why are we going so slow, people? Seat is still too far back, and he needs to slide it forward more. Excuse me while I do that. Let's try that on precise. There we go. Set my head tracker there. Lots of traffic up this way, and they're not moving so fast. What the heck? I'm losing my patience. I realize it's the truck in front that's causing the issue. Right, passing when he doesn't have the power to do it. Yet the car's spacing is, you know, I understand you should have a safe following distance, but 5 seconds between vehicles is just ridiculous. Coming up on Raton, or Raton, whatever, however it's pronounced, so we should be getting off, I think. The second exit? Oh, I see the speed's dropping to 65. Thinking it was that one for some reason. I've never been up this way, so it could be rather mountainous. I don't know. I mean, I've been up this way on I-25, and you know, I've got this hill here, but I don't know this route we're gonna be jumping off at up here. I've never been that way. Thankfully, we don't have that big heavy load we had this morning. Ship down. Weigh scale. I got the green arrow.
Keep left.
Happily keep left.
Keep right, then take the exit right. Take the exit right. Turn right. Keep right, then go straight. Straight.
Right down Main Street, this little town.
Keep right. Then go straight.
I know it looks like I just ran over that car, but I assure you, there's a room between me and him. Cute little town. And then sometimes during these episodes, when I don't have a load, little towns like this, we can actually, you know, we don't have a trailer on, we can actually go exploring on some of it. You know, a lot of them, they look like they have roads, but you can't actually go down them. But there's a lot of them that... they have sights to see, and they'll have a little camera, and you go activate, and it shows you the highlights of the town, I guess. Gate there, so they do close this road off at times during the year, so looks like it's going to be getting up there in elevation. Cranes and windmills. That must mean that they're putting up more crane or more windmills. Yeah, it's a wind farm. Wind farm in production or under construction.
Go straight.
Wide open area, probably, you know, a good place for a wind farm, and in fact it, you know, might actually exist in real life. I don't know, this game does a good job with that kind of stuff. Are not doing 65, so I'm just kind of hanging back. I'm guessing they're about 60 miles an hour. Another brake train. Any time slowing down either, did they? Good lord. Goodness gracious.
Left turn ahead. Turn left. right turn ahead.
This traffic light up there must be where it stopped. Hope we can get through it.
Turn right.
I swear, some of you truck drivers need to go back to school. About an hour's worth of driving and we'll be there. Dear. Not that she was complaining. 45 mph curves. Generally, if it says 45, you can take them at 55, but there are the exceptions. One thing I didn't look for is whether or not we had a truck stop up here in this town. Pause this for a second or check the map. There is something there. Oh yeah. Well, that's a good thing, because we're going to deliver and have to sleep. Also something we should have checked. And that's what's different also about this game as opposed to real life. Real life, you can find a side street and park and do your sleeping. This game, you have to have it be in a designated sleeping spot to sleep, which really is dumb. You can't park on an exit ramp and sleep. I guess they would rather have you pass out, fall asleep, driving down the road, trying to get to some designated place. And there it goes. There's the yawns telling me I'm getting tired. And I agree. We're right at the 11-hour mark coming up here. Thought you were turning to their truck. I was wrong. I should have went ahead and passed you when I had the opportunity.
Go straight. turn left.
Where? Okay.
Turn left. Turn left.
And left again, huh? Damn.
Go straight.
Yeah, okay. I don't think I'm gonna stop at the stop. Ooh. There was a car.
You have reached your destination.
I have reached my destination. Thank you. And I have an easy place to drop my load. Okay, we've been going 53 minutes. My goodness, this one's lasted a long time. So I guess I'm going to end it here, and just check the load board real quick. Oops, I can't do it that way. I got to come to jobs, freight. Well, there you go. Junction City, Kansas. It's right by my home. It's only $1.45 a mile, but it gets me home. Yep. And I have 13 hours, so that means we're going to the truck stop, and then I'll get it. Perfect. Okay, folks. Oh, that's a light load, too. Thanks for watching. Tune again next time, and I'll be at that truck stop where we will carry on. Say goodbye, dear. All right, folks, thanks for watching. Have a good day.